So good afternoon friends, today I will explain the experiment calibration of panel voltmeter using sphere gap arrangement. First question is, why calibration of panel voltmeter? Now you can see this is the control panel for high voltage transformer. In this experiment we will be using 150 kV 15 kVA transformer. This is control panel. Outside this there is auto transformer. Output of the auto transformer is given to the high voltage transformer. Now in high voltage transformer there are three windings: primary rated up to 230 volts, secondary, that is high voltage winding, rated up to 150 kV, and third one is measuring winding. Now across measuring winding this voltmeter is connected, and this voltmeter is calibrated in terms of voltage induced in the high voltage winding. Now most of the test objects which are coming for testing, they are capacitive in nature. Now as they are capacitive in nature, the actual voltage which is appearing across the test object is higher than what this meter is indicating. This meter is just indicating the voltage induced in the measuring winding and calibrated in terms of high voltage winding, but actual voltage across the test object will be higher. Therefore in actual testing, the testing personnel don't rely on this meter. They use independent method for measurement of voltage appearing across the test object. The method can be sphere gap arrangement, capacitance potential divider, resistance potential divider, electrostatic voltmeter, or anything, or any standard method used for high voltage measurement. Okay. So in this experiment we are using sphere gap arrangement for measurement of high voltage across the secondary winding of the transformer, and then we are comparing the readings obtained by sphere gap arrangement and this meter, and we find out how much error is generated during the measurement. This is sphere gap arrangement for measurement of high voltage. You can see here two spheres. The upper electrode, we are giving the high voltage. This electrode is fixed. Lower sphere will be connected to the ground and it is movable. This is the meter indicating the distance between the spheres. At present, it is indicating zero distance. So you can see here, the spheres are touching each other, distance is zero. This is the resistance to control the current when there is spark over between the sphere. Now depending on the dimension of the sphere, the standard characteristic is given by the manufacturer between gap spacing and the spark over voltage. This characteristic is under standard atmospheric conditions, that is 760 mm of mercury and temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. At other temperature and pressure, whatever reading we are getting here for spark over voltage, we have to multiply that by air density correction factor delta, which is function of pressure and temperature. So in this experiment we exploit the characteristic of the breakdown characteristic of the air, that is dielectric strength of the air, that is 30 kV per centimeter. This 30 kV per centimeter is the dielectric strength of the air under standard atmospheric condition. Means if gap spacing is 1 centimeter, temperature is 20 degrees Celsius and pressure is 760 mm of the mercury, we require 30 kV for getting the spark. Here the insulating medium will be air, so accordingly the calibration is there for this sphere gap arrangement, and that is under standard atmospheric condition. Whatever results we are getting, that we have to multiply by air density correction factor delta. The high voltage terminal of this transformer I am connecting to this upper sphere. This is high voltage terminal of the sphere gap element, and this earth point we are I am connecting to this lower sphere. This is earthing point. This cable is going to the controller of this sphere gap arrangement. In that controller there are two knobs, up and down. Down means it will start going down, so distance between the spheres will increase. Up means this sphere will start coming up, so the distance will reduce. This is the controller for sphere gap arrangement. You can see two knobs, up and down. Up will reduce the distance, down will increase the distance. So at present distance is 0 mm, so I will press this down button and make the distance between the spheres is equal to 5 mm or 0.5 cm. Now I am applying the voltage. You can observe the spark between the spheres. So this was the reading with spacing of 5 mm. That is 0.5 cm. The breakdown voltage or spark core voltage was 10 kV. Now I will change the distance to 1 cm, 1.5 cm, and so on, and I will take the readings. By changing the distance in a step of 5 mm, we go up to 50 mm. Now with gap spacing of 50 mm, I am applying the voltage. You can see the spark. Now you can see the voltage. Now you can see the leakage current or spark or current when flashover between the spheres occur. This meter will indicate the current, and the relay which is inside this control panel detects this current and trips the high voltage transformer from the control panel. To note down the pressure and temperature. The pressure gauge, from here we note down the pressure at which the experiment is performed. This is thermometer, it will give the temperature at which the experiment is performed. So by using these two readings we get the air density correction factor delta. From standard table we get the breakdown voltage for 15 cm sphere at different gap spacings, and we do the calculations for calibration of panel voltmeter. Thank you.